Is it recording? Yeah, it's recording.
So, oh shit.
Alright, let's try this again. So it was too windy outside for the camera to actually, I mean the mic to actually pick up on my voice. So it's too windy outside. And I don't really feel comfortable doing this at home because my whole family's home. So I'm sitting in my car right now, and let's try this again. So far all my vlogs have just been me putting together a bunch of clips and calling that a vlog. There hasn't really been much of me talking, so for most of this video it's just gonna be me talking. Nobody asked for this, and it will probably be really boring, but I don't care. This is my channel. I spend pretty much most of my day sitting in the corner of my dining room. Every day is pretty much the same. It's the same routine. There's no more spontaneity in my life anymore. Nothing exciting happens, so I feel the days and weeks are going by faster. Time is a weird thing. Sometimes it drags on, sometimes it'll fly by, but always people end up asking themselves, where did the time go? I only have 2, maybe 3 summer vacations left until I'm an adult with more responsibilities. For sure, it's unfair, but there's still a lot I can be grateful for in this situation. But I guess it's a good thing we know this pandemic won't last forever. The cases are already starting to go down, or at least the curve is not as steep as it used to be. Slowly, our lives will go back to how it was, and we can go back to making the most of our time left on Earth. I shouldn't be worried, but still, there's so much pressure to still be doing stuff and to still be productive while quarantined at home. But my motivation and desire to do anything is at an all-time low. Now's the time to be more introspective and take the time to really ask yourself if you're being motivated externally or internally. I've been running and doing some home workouts occasionally, but lately it's been a struggle to get into anything and finish all the way through. I've been watching a lot of movies. That's something I don't really get time to do at school. I've been reading a lot more too, more than I probably ever have. I start a new book every few days actually. I've decided to jump on the bandwagon and get Animal Crossing. It doesn't seem like I'm going to get an internship this summer, but that's okay. I think with where I'm at right now, it would be worse to waste my time at a job that doesn't really align with where I want to be just so that I can get paid than to spend my summer learning, which I'd much rather do. But listen, basically what my point is, you don't have to be your best self right now. You can get through this any way you can. I can't not do anything, so I've been trying to keep myself busy, very busy like I always do, but you don't have to be super productive. In fact, I should probably spend my time to be more introspective right now. But I have to remember that the situation is different, the factors are different. I have to learn to motivate myself internally rather than let external things motivate me. My family is slowly driving me towards insanity, but FaceTiming and gaming with my friends is keeping me sane. I miss my friends and my frat a lot. It's been so long since I've seen any of them in person. But this is part of the reason why I started a YouTube channel. I wanted a way to keep my friends in my life, even if life separates us. I haven't been uploading as much as I'd like to, but I'm working on that. I'm coming up with ideas. I just gotta find the time to record and edit. So that's what I've been up to. That's what's been on my mind during quarantine lately. I hope my rambling made sense and you weren't too bored. I'm probably gonna cringe a lot while I'm editing that, but I wanted to get more comfortable talking in front of a camera and hearing my own voice. So I feel like that was necessary, and I'm probably gonna do more of that. If you stayed until the end of that whole thing, then you're a real one and I love you. If you stay until the end of the video, you can watch a little montage I put together of my last week here at Rutgers this semester. yeah, that was a really fun week, so I had a lot of fun putting that together. So I hope you enjoy that. But that's pretty much it. I'll see you in the next one. How do you throw the best party ever?
You play good music and you have a lot of themes, and you, I don't know. You got decorations that aren't black because that's a funeral.
Kate, how do you throw the best party ever?
Have Tanae throw it.
Good answer.
You probably kept asking ever until he got that.
How do you throw the best party?
You have Tanae throw for you.
See? Wow, just copied her answer.
Who's copying me? I was not expecting that.
How do you throw an amazing party? What goes into throwing the most amazing party ever?
Gotta have fun people.
Fun people?
Mm-hmm.
How do you throw the best party ever?
You strip.
Till we met a star in the 40s and a fold in the 50s. Got me tripping out like